What's good, YouTube, and welcome to the house with Market Review. So people are freaking the heck out over Hot Red Dragon Archfiend Abyss's prices here, and starting at $56, that's a pretty good reason to freak out. At YCS Chicago, after all the hype, it was above 60. It's climbed down just a little, but not much. There's not really coolant going on here. Why is that? Well, out of High Speed Riders, one of the most open sets for good old Terror Tops and Omegas, this sat around 8 to 13 forever and has become one of the best cards to summon with the Guard Dragons because it can negate any effect. And we've seen the Guard Dragon become used as an engine, not just the deck, as well for the focus from the extra deck within Thunder Dragons by Aaron Furman. I've been testing that list. It is quite a beast of a list. You abuse Saryujas and Guard Dragons in order to be able to continue on. And Saryujas is that amazing extender we were talking about in another video. But Hot Red Dragon Archfiend Abyss hits the board and becomes an Omni Negate. But when I say that, basically it can negate Spell, Trap, or Monster. You can target one face-up card your opponent controls, negate its effects until the end of this turn. So no destruction there, but it also, you know, does other good things. When this card inflicts battle damage to your opponent, you can target a tuner in your graveyard. That could be Destrudo and special summon it in defense. You can only use each effect once per turn. So basically, it's a quick play negate that does what Crystal Wing doesn't. It takes care of spell and traps. Crystal Wing also going up here, which is why it's on Market Watch. Notice it's headed towards that $10 price point. You can still find them a little cheaper over here on eBay, $6 for one before it raises towards $8.50 and quickly meets that $9. But if you don't have either and you're considering playing Guard Dragons and trying to summon both of these, I do highly suggest going ahead and get your Crystal Wing while it's still, you know, a little bit cheaper over here on eBay. Now, back to this, does it deserve this price point? Well, without a reprint and how competitive Yu-Gi-Oh is, unfortunately, I think it is going to stick around 45 to 50, if not higher. Being able to just have that negate, being able to splash it into Thunder Dragons, and the low quantities that want replenish on market, unfortunately, create this perfect storm where it's gonna kind of stay up there. And you really can't underestimate a card that can negate any spell, trap, or monster. Like, as long as it's not a counter trap, John. But seriously, like, the ability to stop a Sky Striker engage or a Widow Anchor, it's just all so freaking good. Speaking of Saryuja, you know, part of that Guard Dragon engine too, we see two of them in some lists, or three. You know, the good old Saryuja Turbos still exist, but we're seeing two of these in certain lists, and $28 for Saryuja. This was naturally coming as it's the chase card out of the Megatons now. And I mean that evenly matched is still up there in price, but it's getting its reprint in Dual Power. They can only short so many cards in Dual Power, right? Right? We see Impermanence, Ghost Spell, great cards from Flood, but also we see out of the Megatons, Boreload, and Evenly Matched, leaving this as the only card not to be reprinted, and people are now playing this in twos, threes, not just ones, and it's going to continue to trickle on up unless it gets hit in the F and L list or reprinted again in Battles of Legend. Battles of Legend, you got other cards to pay attention to also. Please, right before the WCQ, help my players' wallets, please. Seriously, though, Saryuja is an amazing card. It's an extender, it's a hand fixer, it does everything so amazingly, and it helps with the Guard Dragon engine as it's becoming rather than the deck. We do get the Heretic Link monster for them in Dual Power, so hopefully maybe there's some touch to Saryuja on the April FNL list, but for now, if you're playing in events and you're considering playing that Guard Dragon engine, you definitely want to have your hand on at least two of these. Now, I can't believe I'm bringing this up again already, but the Soul Burner Structure deck, we've got Fiends over on eBay canceling freaking orders and then relisting their orders for pre-sales. So it's not like they ran out of stock out of this. It's not like they determined they couldn't get any more. They're canceling pre-sales on eBay and jacking up the prices. I've seen this on Facebook and Zodiac Duelist. It's a terrible business practice. It's one thing if, like, you have to cancel an order because you cannot fulfill it because Crystal Commerce lists your stuff multiple places and didn't take it off for you. When buyouts happen, crazy buyouts after events, that sometimes happens. But for a pre-sale, this is freaking unforgivable. You're a terrible, scummy seller if you are not honoring your pre-sales and just trying to get, like, you order more. But I guess people aren't able to order more and they're trying to maximize their profits. When you do that as a seller, you're going to lose that customer for life. You can list your cheapest cards later and they're going to skip by over you and they're going to remember that name that effed them up basically on a pre-order. Now, I've been telling you guys to make sure to secure your Soul Burner structure decks, and for good reason, they're about to be 15 lowest. We have major vendors like Untapped Games here, and I see Core TCG lowest on eBay helping people out. But basically, this is already above that $10 mark, and it's kind of getting crazy that it goes to 15 so quickly. So definitely consider getting yours for that set of Ash Blossoms. It's a huge difference to be paying around 30 than 45, an extra 50%. And I'm sure people are glad to pay that for the set of Ash Blossoms, but at the same time, it would leave a sour taste in my mouth to have to pay extra. Make sure you guarantee yours. Don't get caught by scummy sellers, even though you can't really predict that one. And know that this structure deck might be just like Dino Master's Fury, a $20 one, because people are going to really want to play those Solomon Greats. They're going to be taking tops at YCS. The chunk of the top cut, I'm unsure of. I personally think three or less tops. But we'll really see at YCS Dusseldorf how good the Solid Boys are doing. Let's start backwards in Savage Strike here with Trickstar Corbane, aka Trickstar Honest, over $10 here on TCG Player. And when we look on eBay, it quickly matches that $10. This is so freaking shorter printed compared to all the other ultras. You can see DZeef's case opening, my own case data from different places. This by far just seems underprinted. Konami's intentions are not. It is freaking underprinted. And Trickstar Players, even though it's stuck in one deck, it seems like it's going to continue going up as Trickstar players who were waiting watch in horror that, oh no, the price ain't dipping. Your best place to get them might be the Savage Strike Special Editions when they come out, though. We'll see how far prices can go. Moving on up, Borreload Savage Dragon sitting almost at $25 here and almost at $25 on eBay, quickly over with only one under. And A, Simply Unlucky continuing on eBay to show up in Market Watch with those competitive prices. Gotta hand it to him, but you can definitely get cheaper here or there. But if you ever want to support a content creator, looks like he's second cheapest here. Man, Borreload Savage Dragon is pretty good, and I told you guys, Destrudo's gonna help make him. You have a 3 and a 4 on board, you use Destrudo with the 3 to pop himself out as a 4. Synchro Shokan, Borreload Savage Dragon. Yeah, this was gonna see play in more than just good old Synchro ability deck. So the moment we saw both Yazzie and Bryonic popping out, it's pretty obvious this was gonna be part of the meta. Will it continue to go up? Every single Borreload so far has, but every single Borreload was secret rare. Well, okay, let's not talk about that Battles of Legend Borreload. What I'm talking about is in the core sets with Sword and Load. This one, I think, will be really odd to see how it falls out when the special editions come out and the quantities go up for what's realistically a one of in most extra decks that play him. But at the same time, right now, it seems like everybody's really grabbing towards him. And finally, Phantasmy is almost a $70 card. I kind of thought at first that when Idly was going to come out, this would tank, but it really serves a different purpose than Idly does in what it can offer and what it can do against multiple different decks. And we see on eBay too, Thanos Dragon is pretty up there. Let's see what happens when we put, yep, 65s, etc. So a little bit cheaper than TCG Player, probably because of that sale that happened recently. But at the same time, demanding this price point of over a box, it's nice to see that at least two cards hit that point, but it kind of sucks to see that they're the shorter printed secret rares in the set overall. So will it fall when Idly comes out? I don't know, maybe by a little bit, Idly can potentially replace what it does, but not in the same way or fashion. I think Phantasmy might still see play in more extra decks. We're not really seeing U-linking happening as much after the ban list. We're not seeing, like, crazy link boards. And Phantasmy can try to come out during stuff like when Guard Dragons are about to summon things. So, very, very interesting good old duality there as we jump towards Pot of Extravagance. Cooling down just a little. It was headed towards 76 after Chicago. It's going to be naturally fluctuating from prices like that. 70 over here on eBay. We have Guru Control, we have Altergeist, but they're not taking up a majority of the top cut, and you have a lot of rogue decks that want to have their eyes on this card. Also, in my opinion, it is overinflated, but the quantities are going to keep it there. This card, I think, waiting for the special editions is the right move versus everything. I'm unsure about a lot of cards, but this, I'm pretty sure its price will be lower when special edition cards are flooding the market. Sekka's Light is going up for the super rares and the rares. There's a lot of them on TCG Player, but there's only 40 copies or 40 different sellers of Sekka's Light between both OTS and Flood on eBay. So you might want to get your rares sooner than later. But people are basically playing this in certain variants of good old Thunder Dragons as well. It's not only a draw two, but a hand fixer. They're choosing it over a lure because, well, after you've drawn two and gotten to fix your hand, it's highly likely you have a playable hand in that deck and are getting to what you want to get to. And then you go into Saryuja, you fix things, you go into Guard Dragons. It's a brand new world, chat. Man, streaming habits. But seriously, Sekka's Light is insane, and I've told you guys to get the supers before when they were at threes, and we see it climbing on eBay as well. So, Sekka's Light, just an amazing card in general. And finally, Danger Thunderbird is rising just a little. Every single danger seems to be targeted for buyouts lately. Just something to keep an eye out. A dollar's not too much movement, but at the same time, you want to keep an eye out because it could quickly rise to $10. So if you've been considering your good old rank 8 dangers or using Thunderbird, such as I believe Edeception did in his list, definitely be deciding whether you should be picking this up sooner or later, as almost every danger we've seen on the market is going nuts and crazy. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed the conversation, and let me know what you think of everything going on. It's been so crazy since Chicago. We're in that full swing of the WCQ season, although we have a potential list again before the WCQ, so that could really shake things up. Thank you so much for watching, everybody.